Continue Google Cloud Dataflow's last-minute cheat sheet. I went through how to aggregate elements in bounded connections through windows, watermarks, and triggers in the last video. Now let's take a look at the key points of the remaining Dataflow's last-minute cheat sheet for the PDE exam. I covered creating jobs and pipelines in the last two videos. Now let's take a look at how to update and stop jobs. Based on the documentation, you cannot update batch pipelines, but you can update ongoing streaming job. You can launch the replace job with the update option and set job name option in the pipeline options to the same name as the job you want to update. If any transform names in your pipeline have changed, you must supply a transform mapping and pass to use the transform name mapping option. Pay attention to the caution. Give explicit names to every transform in your pipelines and the nodes. When you run with the transform name mapping, you may need to escape the quotations as appropriate for your shell. If the job compatibility check fails, you should stop the current job and create a new job instead. Google Cloud Dataflow provides two options to stop a job, cancel and join. Cancel will immediately stop job and abort all data ingestion and processing, so any buffered data will be lost. The join command is currently only supported for streaming pipelines. It will attempt to finish processing any remaining buffered data, so if you saw any question in the exam that you needed to update a streaming pipeline but you do not want to lose any data when making this update, then choose the join option to stop your job, tells the Dataflow service to finish your job in its current state. The next topic for the exam is the access control. You only need to remember four IAM rules for the Dataflow. Dataflow admin, which is for pipeline access plus machine type storage bucket configuration access. Dataflow developer, which is for pipeline access, no machine type storage bucket access. Dataflow viewer, read-only access to all Dataflow related resources. Dataflow work, specified for the service accounts to execute work units for the Dataflow pipeline. You will also have the question on how to handle the errors and exceptions from Dataflow pipeline. So take a time to review the details of common errors and pay attention to these two kinds of errors. One is the input and output errors, and the other one is the coding-related exceptions. For example, exception from a pardo, dofn, and combine functions. I had a question on handling dofn exceptions. If the failure is within the processing code of a dofn, one way to handle this is to catch the exception, log an error, and then drop the input. The rest of elements in the pipeline will be processed successfully, so progress can be made as normal, but just logging the elements isn't ideal because it doesn't provide an easy way to see these malformed inputs and reprocess them later. A better way to solve this would be to have a data later file where all of the failing inputs are written for later analysis and reprocessing. We can use the side output in the data flow to accomplish this goal. You need to check the latest Apache Beams SDKs on how to handle the exceptions before the exam. I will go through the comparison between Dataflow and Dataproc, two data processing services from Google Cloud, the comparison between Dataflow and Dataprep, two data preparation services from Google Cloud, and the sample Dataflow PDE questions in the next video. Thanks for watching, and as always, subscribe to my channel for more great cloud computing learning tips. See you next time.